All right, Charles, what do you think?
I don't know, but I know how to do it.
All right.
I'm just going to substitute in the equation we had before.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Uh-huh. Right, so m is greater than or equal to 1 over epsilon times the natural log of the size of the hypothesis space.
Mm, which is what? That's not one of our variables here.
10.
Yeah. Right, so it's not 2 to the 10. Even though the input space is 2 to the 10, the number of hypotheses, there's one hypothesis corresponding to each of the bit positions. So, good.
Right. Plus the natural log of 1 over delta. So that would be greater than or equal to 10 times the natural log of 10 plus the natural log of 5. So let's see. The natural log of 10 is something like 3 point something. Natural log of 5 is something like 2 point something. We add those up, multiply it by 10. You're going to end up with 39.12.
So we need, 40 samples?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
That actually doesn't sound too bad. Though, it's not learning a very hard problem, but it's, it's a pretty big input space.
So let's see. How big is the input space? It's 2 to the 10, which is 1,024.
1,024.
Yeah. So how much of 1,024 is 40? Less than 4%. That's not bad.
Before we leave this quiz, let me point out one more thing, that this bound is actually agnostic to the distribution from which samples came. So this idea that it's from a uniform distribution is actually not being directly used here. So so this is pretty cool. It actually doesn't matter. We only need 40 samples no matter what the distribution is. It's not like some distributions are harder or easier because we are measuring the true error on the same distribution that we use to create the training set. So if it's a really hard distribution and some tough examples never appear, then we're unlikely to see them in the training set, but they're not going to contribute very much to the true error.
Well, that makes sense. So the right. So in some sense, I guess the equation doesn't show this, but in some sense, the distribution cancels out between the training and the true error.
Yeah, that's one way to think about it.
That's one way to think about it like that. So 40 is pretty good to get 10% error. If we wanted to get, say, only 1% error, then we would go from 40 to 400.
Mm. Right? That's a good point, yeah.
And it's one decimal point even. And so that would be about 40% of the data.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah, and if we want to go a little bit beyond that, we may need all the data multiple times.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but this example doesn't look so bad. So let's just move on before we think about it too hard.
Okay, that seems fair. I like that.